Have you ever procrastinated testing your design, ended up testing too late, and then realized you were on the complete wrong track the entire time? Testing way too late is how many startups lose millions of dollars. I found three common reasons when a designer tests a design too late. First, you're a perfectionist and want to improve your design further before showing it to other people. Second, you're an introvert and talking to other people just costs way too much energy. Third, your company is cheap, and your boss thinks that they know it all. I've experienced all this, and I have a few tips for you to test early, test faster, and test cheaper. I'm Aliena, and let's use the legendary double diamond process graph to explain a few of my tips. In the discovery and define stage, we need to understand what is the problem we're trying to solve and who's the target user. We also need to understand what is outside the scope and who's not our target user. If you don't define what's outside the scope, you will end up with rounds of iterations, unable to find a solution that satisfies everyone, and probably ending up designing a huge decision tree with so many features. And you might think, well, finally, this will help a lot of people. But in reality, having that many options and features will confuse everybody. I suggest you to talk to users in this early stage. It's called conducting a user interview. And I suggest you to send out those invitations before you feel like you're fully ready. If you have contact information of your users, then awesome. But if you don't, or if you don't have enough time to find those people yourself, you can use a UX research tool like Listna to recruit participants. They have a research panel to help you find the people you need. They also have an interview feature to help you schedule interviews, send invites, qualify or disqualify participants. When I started my design journey, I thought I need to spend a lot of time and prepare very, very thoroughly before a user interview. Turns out I could have just chilled a little bit. Now, in my own company, I asked my design team to schedule user interviews right after our first meeting of a project. Once we send out those invitations, the deadline will push us to prepare. During the user interviews, I prefer to talk in a more casual style to help the participant open up a little bit. It's also easier for me. I am not the most professional speaker. And instead of keep thinking about the script, what is the next question to ask? Our job as a designer is to listen and also observe the energy shift and the emotional shift of the participant. You can also ask, how does this step make you feel? When you are taking notes, try not to rephrase what they say, but rather write down exactly what the participant is saying. It takes up less brain power from your end, and it also helps to avoid changing the tone or changing the meaning. If your company uses a research tool like Listna, then great! You just need to turn on the transcript feature. And even if you carefully select your participants, you may still realize that some of the participants are not just 100% relevant to the problem you're solving. There will be few participants that are super passionate about the problem. In this case, try to understand why, and use this information to further help you understand who's the right target audience here. A product that's designed for everyone is a product that's designed for nobody. Did I say that right? I'll put the right thing here. If you work for a startup, though, your boss is likely to ask you to skip the user interview step. Why? Because your boss has spent so much time doing that, understanding the problem, understanding the target user, and trying to discover a solution themselves before they hire you. So in this case, try to set up enough meetings to get enough information from them. You can also ask them, can I just have 10 emails of our current users? I'd like to set up a quick call with these users to understand them better, build a relationship, and understand our product better. If you're an introvert working in a startup or working on your own personal project, you may try to use a survey to replace user interviews. My preference is always user interviews better than survey because nothing can beat talking to people face to face. But survey comes in a close second and can bring another perspective to your research, especially gathering some quantitative data. If you work in a large company with a lot of other stakeholders, then it is actually unlikely that you will do a user interview in the beginning stage, because your product manager and the leadership would have finished these steps for you. In this case, you should learn from internal stakeholders and documents, do secondary research, and try out the product yourself. So first thing first, host a few meetings with your product manager and the leadership to understand what's happening. What is the problem? What's the project? Never jump into coming up with a solution before fully understand the problem. Also, don't assume they know it all. You may realize that they don't know it all, and you'll have to circle back to ask for more data. You can also talk to data analysts, talk to the marketing team, or even talk to customer service. They are closer to customers. Another thing I highly recommend is trying out your own product. When I was at eBay, I designed for pay-per-click advertising. So in order to try out my own product, I have to become an eBay seller first. And it's not just like selling one-off t-shirt. Our ad works better for product with many stocks. So I bought an entire box of Coach wristlet. I still have many left, and I try out the entire ads product myself. I intentionally use my own money, and I have to earn that back, just like any other eBay seller. It forces me to look at things not from the traditional creator top-down point of view, but rather the user bottom-up point of view. It showed me things that I never thought of before. Try out your own product. In the development stage, this is where usability testing usually happens. However, most companies test way too late, probably 7 days before they go into engineering stage. If you test this late, you are not looking for feedback. You're just betting that users like your design and you don't have to change anything. This is not good. There are many reasons why companies tend to test way too late. One being that you might need to work with a UX researcher that's outside your team, and you have to submit all sorts of documents, go through an entire process to get it done. So you procrastinate, and the next thing you know, you're already way too late. Another possibility is that you are sinking into an infinite loop of internal feedback. Everyone in your company gives your suggestion one after another, and each time you receive the suggestion, you iterate because you want to make everyone happy, so you never have the chance to test outside your company. There are two levels of problem we need to tackle here. First is mindset, and second is tactics. Let's start from mindset. I used to think that as a good designer, I need to take everyone's feedback and make everyone happy. I will make you burn out for sure. Now, I understand the importance of prioritizing wisely and testing faster, even if it means I need to go into a meeting while sharing my screen and directly drawing the wireframe in the meeting. There's no need to take everyone's feedback, and there's no need to make everything pretty. On the tactic level, I would arrange a meeting to pull in all relevant stakeholders and ask them for feedback and ideas before I even draw anything out. Then, I'll take everyone's suggestions, use the ones that I think worth implementing, and then create a wireframe. Then I'll arrange another big meeting so that everyone can roast my wireframe. And after that, I'll move into high fidelity, but from that time on, I'll reduce the time of asking feedback from internal stakeholders and prioritize on asking feedback from external users. In this way, I gather feedback early, I test faster, and I avoid jumping on so many small one-on-ones. This will definitely ease out your design process and make you feel better, but this will never 100% prevent the following situation. You are on your 10th hi-fi iteration, and your team brings on a new designer. And this designer is their first week in this company. They jump on a one-on-one call with you and look at your design, and they immediately be like, "Have you thought about a tab here instead of this?" And then you will have to go all the way back to your third iteration and show them, "Yes, I've tried a tab here. It didn't work because of ABC. It kind of sucks, but let's be grateful for that. Because I think it's way better for us to be immersed in an environment where feedbacks are welcomed, compared to isolating ourselves and keep iterating only based on our own bias and assumptions. Okay, usability testing. Usability testing is different from user interviews in that you actually have a prototype to test things out. Usability testing focuses on the solution, whereas user interviews focus on the problem. Here's the good news. Usability testing also doesn't need a long time to prepare. If you are productive, a 30-minute meeting with your product manager or your boss is enough. Just write out an agenda, a few key questions, and a task for the user. You can spend a day or two creating the prototype for the task. During the usability testing session, you can give your participant a prototype link, or else you can just share your screen, present the prototype yourself, and ask them what would you do next given this screen. And let's say they say, "I would like to click that button." Then instead of directly clicking the button for them, ask another question. What do you expect to see after you click the button? In this way, you will understand their expectation, and then you can compare whether your design meets their expectation. Especially, we don't want the surprise where a user thought that they didn't pay for certain stuff, but turns out they've paid for a feature they don't even know. Those are the things that will put your company into court. I also see that many companies only test once. I get it, we are all working under an ASAP deadline. And at the last mile of the marathon, it is only the caffeine and the 24-hour lo-fi music that's pushing you forward. So, did I figure out a way to test multiple rounds while preserving the sacred energy of a designer? Yes, of course. One way is to arrange this test very early, so that by the end, you have no choice because you already arranged the testings. Another way is using tools like Listener, so you don't have to jump on the calls yourself. Let me show you. Listener can handle pretty much all the primary research types you can imagine. It's the go-to research tool for many tech companies. The flow I'm about to show you is for creating a prototype test. You can choose between task flow and free flow. I prefer the task flow. First, write a short instruction about the task you want the participant to complete. Then paste in your Figma prototype link. Click Pick a Goal screen and click through your prototype to arrive at the last screen of your task flow. Set it as the Goal screen. Once the participant arrives at this screen, it'll count as a success, and your following questions will pop up. For this example, I'll just ask for a rating on the overall experience and the Net Promoter Score. Once you set up your test, you can either recruit from Listener's panel of 530k people or recruit participants yourself. If you need to find a very specific age group, country, or certain behavior preferences, their panel is really good. Once you finish the setup, this is how a participant will take your usability test. They'll go through the test on their own without you needing to host another Zoom meeting. After the test, the results are presented to you with very clear metrics and analysis. If you want to learn more and use Listener, click the link in the description and I'll include any latest discount code. In summary, testing early and testing frequently is a win-win for you, your company, and your customers. So let's make testing a design routine and a company culture. Schedule a call now with your customers. You will not regret it. I'm Aliena. If you like this video, you shall subscribe, and I will see you in this video. And thank you, Listener, for sponsoring today's video.